The importance and the dangers of art. Art is very important. We all know this. If you listen to Bach, Beethoven, you love music, whatever music you love, you understand this emotion. When you listen to it, it gets to the depths of who you are, all right? Especially music is very direct. There is some art that is very direct, like music. It is beautiful. You have this sense of beauty, of truth, and you know, emotion, and what it is to be human and sentient. You also have the indirect, like a movie. For example, some deep movies, it will digest in you. You will digest it for months and months and years and years, all right? Until it's within you and it grows and grows within you. Music is more direct, immediate, all right? You can feel these deep emotions, you might even cry and so forth. Music is very powerful, but movies are also very powerful. Games can be powerful. There is no art I'm denying. I'm not denying any medium. All the artistic mediums are fine. All artistic mediums are fine. Poems also, paintings also. All of them are fine, not fine within, you know, it's not like I like all sorts of, you know, paintings. It has to be deep, impactful. It has to be about the human condition, because art should also aid us. The same way philosophy should aid us, but art is the expression of this, while philosophy is the practical aid in life. It's also the theoretical aid in life of thinking and, you know, creating ideas to understand ourselves, but also creating like my tools and guidance. It ignites your inner life, the will to greatness. Art can ignite, you know, your inner salamander. It can get to your instincts. You know, our ancestors, they painted for a reason. You know, the cave people, the cave, you know, Cro-Magnon, they painted these beautiful animals and painted themselves with the animals. They were very spiritual. Art is deeply connected to spirituality, the spiritual feeling, you know, the spirit, the breath, the inner life of you, the salamander, as I call it, you know, the survival instinct as well, the survival within you, the you, the core, your core, the deepest parts of you, the depths, but also the heights. Art should also pull you out and inspire you to the heights. The same way Zarathustra, he goes deep within. He shows, actually Nietzsche shows in Das Buch Zarathustra, the depths, but also the heights. That is why Zarathustra is one of the, you know, greatest masterpieces out there. Lord of the Rings is also this grace, this, you know, heights. Lord of the Rings is all about the heights. You know, this can inspire you. I was thinking of who I would create as a team, you know, for war today. I would use all these different, even YouTubers, certain ones, all the strong ones, I will use them. I would be in the forefront. I would be the king. I would be Aragorn and saying, you know, for Frodo, this is deeply spiritual, and I'm just moving as the, you know, leader, just moving right into the enemy, all right? And that is what we want to do in life, in everything. And this is how art can help you also. You think of, you know, the Lord of the Rings, and this ignites in you, you know, a will to do more repetitions and getting your greater body and helping you in life. That is how art can help you in life. You can think of it this way, all right? Not just ruminate on what does Lord of the Rings mean. No, you don't care about what does this mean, what does Frodo symbolize, and of course you can think of that as well. Frodo symbolizes, you know, the hero's journey. All the heroes are the overcomers of themselves. Frodo is my philosophy. So, of overcoming your old self, or lower desires, getting to your higher desires, and Frodo represents this. He's throwing the ring out there, destroying the enemy, Sauron, with the ring, with everything, but he's sacrificed a lot. But you also have to sacrifice in life. So that is what every story teaches you, sacrificing the lower desires, getting to higher desires, all right? But Das Buch Zarathustra also teaches you how to go within yourself and understanding your psychology, all right? And going upwards. So, you know, Nietzsche is more psychologist, while Tolkien is much more, you know, he's not a psychologist, he's a mythologist, all right? It's different. It's even better with Aragorn, because he's the king, he's the leader, he's the one who But Frodo is, you know, a part of his purpose. He has his purpose, Frodo has his purpose. They both had to sacrifice. Aragorn sacrificed a lot as well. A lot of the characters, they sacrificed a lot. All right, even Aragorn, he sacrificed himself, basically, you know? Every time he's in war, he's sacrificing himself. He's basically, you know, taking the biggest risk there is. That is why I'm very spiritual when I speak of this, and very, you know, I feel even goosebumps when I do this, and even when I thought about it earlier. But there can be a negative side of art where you always ruminate and always avoid yourself. So it used to be that I was watching movies. I watched so many movies. I've seen like 5,000 movies, all right? I've seen so many movies. And it's fine. You can become a film critic, for example. But then you are a creator, all right? Then you're active. My previous video, you see, all of them are connected. Then you're active, you're creating something, you're not just passive. But the danger of art is that you can become passive. You just, it's like a Cro-Magnon just staring at the painting. Never, you know, getting out there, creating a new painting and, you know, getting new food and, you know, killing other, you know, bisons or, you know, whatever it is for food. And then got a new spiritual experience and experience. And then he painted and expressed this experience. That is art. The expression of experience, that is art, all right? It's easy to just, you know, ruminate and delve deep into this and just listen to music and often depressive music. If you're depressed, often, you know, depressed melancholic music or movies that are depressed and melancholic. And this only, you know, makes you even go further and question your core even further, you know? The questioning of core. Stop questioning that core, your health. You have to love the core, all right? And that's the danger of art, that you can become hating yourself, hating, you know, especially if you're depressed and you keep on, you know, watching this stuff because you relate to it. So that's the danger there. You keep on relating to it, so you want to have more of it because someone is understanding you, but that's not the solution. You can't just keep on doing that because that will only lead to ending existence, all right? It can only lead to that, or a very terrible existence, unhealthy, all right? It is unhealthy. By definition, it is unhealthy. A Cro-Magnon would not do this. He has to go out there and, you know, provide food for himself as well. So it's not just, you know, about the tribe and helping the tribe. It's also about himself surviving. The deepest salamander instinct, the core, go from core and outwards, all right? We go out and hunt, all right? Like a warrior, we go out there and get the enemy. We don't ruminate. And you're avoiding yourself all the time. You watch, I even said, I often used to say that I wanted to become the movie. I wanted to be in the movie, literally in the movie. I wanted to be in movie. And that is the ultimate avoiding yourself. That is the ultimate fantasy. I want to be in World of Warcraft. I want to be in a video game. I want to be in Call of Duty or whatever it is right now. I want to be in all of these you know, games, or it doesn't matter if it's game, it's all art, all right? It's all art. It can even be ballet. It can even be, you know, Bach or something. I listen to Bach. And that too was, you know, in within this danger. I can listen to it now, not being in the danger, but that's because I'm active, I've developed myself. You have to be active, not passive, undeveloped. You have to be developed. The active is development, the passive is passivity, is undevelopment, all right? So stop avoiding yourself. That's why when I say stop avoiding yourself, this is it. This is what I mean. You stop avoiding yourself. You stop, you know, always ruminating, always listening to this negative music and watching these negative movies and reading these negative books as well. Books also. All the mediums, all art. I don't care what it is, paintings also. All art. Doesn't matter. And everything you read as well. Poems and, you know, Bukowski, he's very depressing. All right, he's very depressing. And unhealthy, and he was undeveloped, and, you know, not just him, not just him, in philosophy as well, you know? Those who smoke, like Camus, he smoked, so he was, parts of him was very undeveloped, but he had, you know, some he had a lot of activity and he was creating, so it's not just that. But imagine if he was well developed as well, that would be, he would be even better. Imagine if Tolkien could do 1,000 push-ups. So let's take Heraclitus, combine it with a great warrior like Napoleon, something like that, and you create something incredible. That is how you create something incredible. But you can't do that when you're passive, avoiding yourself all the time in art, ruminating all the time. You gotta stop that. You gotta stop this.